Charging is complete. The test will commence in 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1. The vehicle is underway.
Based on our most recent crash tests, minivans have room for improvement. In our updated moderate overlap test, we tested 4 minivans and all of them received marginal or poor ratings. We launched the updated moderate overlap test last year after research showed that for newer vehicles, the risk of fatal injury was higher for belted rear-seated occupants than front-seat occupants. And it's not that the rear seat has gotten less safe over time, it's that the front seat has gotten so much safer by comparison. In this updated test, we're looking closely at the rear occupant. We want to see a low risk of injury and restraint systems that keep that occupant away from the hard surfaces in the vehicle. Many consumers choose minivans specifically to transport their families. So it's disappointing that the automakers haven't focused more attention on backseat safety in this vehicle class. We tested four minivans, the Honda Odyssey, the Toyota Sienna, the Kia Carnival, and the Chrysler Pacifica. And in all four minivans, we saw the rear occupant at risk for chest injury, either because of high belt forces or poor belt positioning. The Sienna is the only minivan where we saw submarining, which is when the lap belt slides over the pelvis into the abdomen and can put the rear passenger at risk of abdominal injury. The Honda Odyssey was the only minivan in this group to earn a poor rating. Compared with the others, it had a higher risk of head and neck injury for that rear passenger. These ratings don't change our recommendation that children under 13 sit properly restrained in the rear seat, and the ratings don't apply at all to children who are restrained in child safety seats. While we're disappointed in these ratings, we expect the automakers to respond quickly and make improvements, as we've seen when we've introduced other tests.